So I'm trying to practice what I'm gonna look like once my hair is done, because I feel like short hair and glasses go hand in hand together. Like short hair and some cool ass glasses, they're like bread and butter. So this is me practicing. So we're just gonna pray and hope I don't fuck it all up. Okay. So I'm about to do a couple things right now. A couple things that I've never done before. I've never ever colored my own real hair ever in my life. And as you guys can see, I cut my hair again. Yeah, because I can. About to do something really crazy. I'm extremely nervous. But I've been thinking about this for years. And today's the day. Today is the motherfucking day. Because if I don't do it now, when will I ever do it? Only got one life to live. So here we go. I pray I don't burn off my whole hair. I mean, even if I do, I think I'm still gonna be all right. You know, like, it's just hair, it'll grow back. Yeah. But I'm still nervous because I want it to look nice. I want it to still look nice, hello. I also want to do finger waves. Well, maybe something like a slight wave at the front, because obviously I'm not going to be able to see the back. I really don't know how this is going to go down. Okay? I'll be natural right now. And I'm going to need a relaxer for that. And it's also kind of like taboo to relax your hair and color it at the same time. So I'm about to execute that idea. And hopefully everything goes well. I've never used this relaxer before, but I just got back from my beauty supply store. Mazzani Butter Blend. I decided to try it because I heard some good things about it. And I got the fine / color treated hair, even though my hair is not color treated yet. And my hair is definitely not fine. In relaxers, I normally get like a regular, but I'm trying to minimize the damage as much as possible. I really don't know what I'm doing. I have an idea, but I'm really not sure. Part of me don't want to relax my hair though. I kind of want to leave it natural. I'm kind of liking this whole natural moment. But I feel like in order for me to have it look the way that I want it to, I'm going to have to visit a barber for them to kind of like level it up and shape it up and all that shit. But I really don't want to do all that. I just want to add some waves. So I'm going to relax it. And I was doing my little research to determine whether what I'm trying to do makes sense at all. A lot of people advise that you relax your hair first before you color it. Even though I can wait like at least 2 weeks like they recommend before, you know, coloring hair after relaxing. I really don't want to. Like, I'm impatient. Like, I just want to do it all and get it over with. Type of thing. Okay? So, we're going to relax first. Wish me luck. I mean, worst case scenario, all my hair falls out, then I'm bald. But, I mean, it's gonna grow back, right? I've never done shit like this before. I hopefully, because this is chemicals and I'm kind of worried. Because I could literally burn your whole scalp off. Well, maybe I'm exaggerating. Okay, I'm talking too much. This is my nervousness talking right now. Like, I'm actually shaking. I've never been so nervous in my life to do some hair. And I think it's because it's gonna be directly done onto my own head. So, whew, my chest is beating. All right, so I have my Vaseline hair to protect my skin. And I might be squinting and just looking a little weird from time to time because I can't see far away. And the mirror is quite far. So, yeah. You have to put things everywhere. This is so weird to me. I've never, I, Have I ever relaxed my hair on camera before? I usually just do that on my own time. Like, I feel like that's such a personal thing. Maybe not personal, but just more so. I don't know. I just never did. So I'm gonna be using an applicator brush because I can't find a glove right now to protect my hands. So I'm trying to not use my hands as much as possible. And I just start. It smells so bad. Actually, let me set my timer because I want to make sure I work fast. I'm trying to do all this within 10 to 15 minutes. I think that's like good enough time. All right. And I don't want to do the front yet because, you know, that's my edges. I want to have edges. So I usually do my edges last when I relax my hair. Alright, so the processing time is almost up, and I'm just gonna follow up with the steps 4 and 5, which are pretty much the shampoo and conditioner, like the neutralizing shampoo and conditioning steps, and they're both by Mazzani as well. And the step 4 is a perfecting cream normalizing conditioner. Yeah, the way they spelled it, it's probably meant to like balance your pH or something. So it says this is the step 4, and the step 5 is the neutralizing and chelating shampoo. I don't know, Mazzani is just different. I've never used this brand before, so we're about to see what it's really about. I'm gonna go ahead and do this off camera. Once it's all washed out, I'm gonna come back and continue. So I just completed the steps 4 and 5 of the Mazzani relaxer treatment, and I would definitely say this is probably one of the times that my hair has ever felt like the least fragile right after relaxing. And I'm looking at it, it doesn't look like it processed too straight, like if you get what I mean. Like, it still kind of look like, I mean, you won't really see it well because it's still wet, but it doesn't feel too straight. And that's probably because, you know, I got the fine slash color treated formula. But either way, like, I'm fine with it. And when I do color it, I do know that it will probably get straighter, because whenever you color hair, you know, that's chemical processing as well, and it tends to alter your hair texture even further. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and let it completely air dry. I'm trying not to add heat to it at all. All right, so my hair is mostly dry. It's pretty much dry. You can see that it's not completely straight. Like, it still has a lot of texture. I'm gonna be using the textures and tones. I was actually gonna use like an actual color, but since this doesn't require you to bleach your hair first, I decided this might be a good idea. And it says it's formulated for black people's hair. Like, that would make a lot of difference, right? And it's designed by black women for black women, so I thought, why not? Yeah, so I'm just gonna mix it up. Whew, whew, my heart is beating so fast. Oh my god, this is not good. Okay, let's do this. Let's mother freaking do this. If my hair melts off, I'll blame it on you guys. But yeah, this is the conditioner. I don't need this yet. Oh my god, my skin is so dry. But I can't moisturize till I'm done, because I still have to wash off the color. This is the developer, and this is the color. I'm just gonna pour this in here, mix it up, add it to my hair. Protect the hands. Yo, I look like a hoodlum. I think Nigerians will understand when I say that. Like, look at my hair. Chai, it's not easy at all. So far, so good. I'm combing it and my hair is not falling out. So I'm just gonna cover it up with a plastic bag. I ran out of shower caps. Well, I ran out of the plastic ones. It says to leave it on for 20 minutes. I think I'm gonna do 30. Because my hair was not bleached prior, I'm afraid it might not take to the color fast. So actually, I'll check in 20 minutes and see what it looks like. If it's still black, I'm just gonna leave it on slightly longer. It's been 20 minutes. So now it's time for the moment of truth. Okay. If I comb it to see, it looks like burgundy. And my hair is still not falling out. Oh my god, I'm so geeked right now. This was my worst nightmare. You know how people, they be like combing their hair, like what color in it? Like there's literally nothing in the comb. Okay, I'm not mad at it. But I really want my hair to be kind of like a gingery, coppery color though. Doesn't look gingery from the look of it. It looks more like burgundy or copper at the most, but should I leave it on a little bit more? I've made the final decision to leave it on for another 15 minutes because I'm afraid if I wash it off, it's still gonna be black in a lot of the areas. Like, so I'm gonna wait another 15 minutes and see what happens. All right, so it's been like 10 minutes later. So pretty much 10 minutes plus the initial 20 minutes. So 30 minutes in total. My head is tingling and I do not wanna risk it. So I'm gonna go ahead and just wash it off and see what happens. I'm gonna wash it and then use the conditioner that comes with it. So the color's been rinsed off. And I'm applying the Intense Hydrating Conditioner right now. And you guys can see the gingery color is actually popping through. I'm gonna leave this in the hair for 30 minutes. And I'm so happy right now because my hair is literally not falling out like this. Nothing in the comb. I'm actually surprised at my hair because my hair is not the strongest naturally. So for it to still be alive and still on my head, it's a miracle. Like if I pull it, nothing is literally coming out. Like it's so strong. But anyway, let's not speak too soon. Let me wash off this conditioner first and see how things go. Once 30 minutes is up, I'm gonna rinse it off, moisturize it, and literally go to bed. And we continue in the morning because it's late right now. We're gonna style it in the morning, okay? All right, see you guys in the morning. All right, so it's morning. Good morning. So, got the face on. Now we're about to tackle this hair. I've never done finger waves ever in my hair or anybody's hair or not even on a wig. I've always like shied away from it because, I don't know, it just looks complicated. And I just felt like, you know, it takes a special kind of artistic person to nail it. I don't know much about finger waves, so my finger waves are probably gonna not look the best. But I do know that you have to use mousse. And a lot of people use a Nairobi. That's what I'm gonna be using. I'm also gonna be using a comb. A lot of people use like a rat tail comb. I mean, I think as long as the tooth or the teeth on the comb is fine enough, like you don't need it to be exactly like a rat tail comb. I don't know. But I know you need a comb like this that looks something like this and mousse. I don't know if you have to put hairspray at the end or if you have to tie it down. I'm guessing you don't have to tie it down because if you do, it'll probably mess up the waves a little bit. I don't know. But I'm not gonna tie mine down. I'm not gonna put any other products but this. And hopefully everything goes well. You guys can kind of like already see the color. It's so weird whenever I don't have like hair. I look like a potato head. I think I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna part. Do you even part your hair when you do finger waves? I don't even know. I'm so confused. A lot of mousse. It's so cold. I read somewhere the trick is to put a lot of mousse. Like, a lot of mousse is way better than not enough mousse. So just slather it on, because that way you're gonna be able to really, you know, maneuver the hair and place it wherever you need to place it. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. I'm so flipping nervous. You guys don't even understand. I'm trying to see the mirror and at the same time be in the shot. So, okay. Wait. This is so nerve-wracking. Okay, let's do this again. Okay, so. Okay, I think this comes forward. And then, oh my gosh, I feel like, wow, that was a mess up. Okay, let's try this again. Yo, my hands are shaking. Okay, let's do this. I feel like my hair is too long. Like I need it to be shorter or something. I don't know what is going on this side. I'm just gonna move on to this side and see what happens. I'm gonna come back to this. I really don't know what's going on. Yeah, this is harder than people be making this shit look. Like people be like, and I'm like, what the it's not swishing. It's not doing what I needed to do. Okay. I think we're getting somewhere. I'm getting there. I'm gonna get this. Just give me a second. I'm so determined for this shit to look decent. Like, it doesn't even have to look perfect. I want it to look decent. I'm gonna do the rest off camera, like, so I can really see the mirror, because the mirror is really far away and I can't see. So hopefully when I'm done, it looks really good. Okay, pray for me. Okay, I did something. I don't know if this even counts as waves, because it just looks like I just did like super huge swoops and then the back is just straight. But I think I'm gonna attempt to add some waves in the back. If it doesn't look good, I'm just gonna smooth it out and make it straight, because I can't see the back. Honestly, I'm not even going anywhere. I'm just gonna take pictures from the front and call it a day. But let me try and see if I can do the back. I feel like I need more mousse right there. Feeling that doesn't look good. Let me look at it in the mirror. Oh my gosh. I mean, it looks alright, I guess. I'm gonna do the rest I'm gonna do the rest and come back and show you guys what everything is looking like. I don't know. I'm kind of laughing at myself, but hopefully it all turns out well. The back looks really bad. Like, I'm so embarrassed about the back. I don't even think I'm gonna show you guys because I don't want you guys to laugh at me. I don't want you to laugh at me. I even try to do, like, you know, little design swirlies at the front. You know, just to jazz it up. And I don't even think these are finger waves. They just look like big ass swoopy swoops that I just managed to do. I like the color. I feel like if someone is able to wave my hair for me, that would be great. Probably during my next, maybe like relaxer touch up, I'm gonna go to a salon and have them do a proper finger wave. Cause right now, this just looks like big ass swoops and like some swirlies. Then they can trim my hair and make sure, you know, it's not too long. Or maybe I might bump it the next style that I do. That's it. Actually, let me try on the glasses. Because, you know, I was looking forward to the whole glasses and the short hair vibe, you know. And, you know, we gotta see what it looks like. It just doesn't mess up my hair. My nose is so tiny. Nothing never want to stay up. Okay. Am I giving face? Am I giving hair? Success. My hair didn't fall out. I achieved the color that I wanted. I was able to somewhat achieve the style. Like, this is not the style, but we can work with this, okay? I can still take my pictures and still look cute, Abby. But yeah, you guys, relaxing your hair and coloring it in one day, please, I'm not telling you that you should do it, but I'm just sharing my experience with you guys and how mine turned out. The state of your hair might be different from mine. The texture of your hair, you know, all these things, you gotta put them into consideration. I'd honestly say just go to a hairstylist. Like, I don't want y'all hair falling out. Because even though it's just hair and it can grow back, it can also damage your scalp and cause you to have permanent hair loss, I think, because they're chemicals. Like, if they burn your scalp, you're pretty much done, I think. But anyway, these are chemicals we're talking about. Take precautions, please. Don't be like me. I did it because I was kind of impatient and curious to see what's gonna happen. And at the same time, I was kind of not scared to lose my hair, even though it would hurt, because I've been looking forward to doing the style, but I didn't mind losing my hair, so I was willing to take a bit more risk, if that makes sense. But here we are. Yes, I love the color, definitely. I was so nervous it was gonna not be as light as I wanted because I didn't bleach it. And keep in mind, the hair is still a little wet, so this is not even like the true color. Is slightly darker than it actually turned out right now, but you get the vibes. You get the vibes. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching just as much as I enjoyed playing around and almost fucking up my hair. But yeah, and I'll see you guys soon. She's back, and she's back to stay. Okay. See you guys soon. Bye.